Hi everybody, great to see you today. Thanks for tuning in. This is a channel where I talk about faith and encouragements and anything uplifting or inspiring to help us in our daily lives. You know, I want to give you a little bit of inkling of hope today, just in the matter of relationships. If you happen to be in a broken relationship, or you're always in conflict with somebody that is in close proximity of you, whether it's a family member, or if it's a relative, or the person at work that's always nearby, somebody that you just cannot get away from, I hope that you may not give up just that little inkling of lighter hope that maybe there may be a day that your relationship may come to a resolution, come to light, and come to genuine care, love, and compassion for each other. You may think to yourself, oh, there is no way possible, you know, this person who I'm in conflict with, you know, we just have personality clash, or they did us wrong, there's no way that I can forgive another person. And we may feel frustrated and let down, disappointed many times with others. And it's so hard, isn't it, that we just can't change another person. For the life of us, you know, we would love others to change just so we can somehow get along, do the right thing, but it's hard. I like what it says in Psalms 27. God says for us to just wait on the Lord, wait on the Lord and be courageous, you know, and just to trust in Him always in every matter, and He will be with us. He will strengthen our hearts. And what does that mean? You know, even though that we may feel that when we're in those broken relationships, whether it may be with our spouse or our children, our neighbors, or anybody, our relatives, brothers, sister-in-laws, sons, daughters, whoever, it's just so, it seems to be so long going and constant. You know, there seems to be no resolvement in the issues, the many, many different ugly issues that has been built up throughout the months or years, you know, however long it may be. And you think that there can be no way that there may come to a time of harmony and peace and love, and just to just get along, you know, just to be at that stage. I was motivated to make this video today for all of you because recently I had the permission to share with you this lovely lady that I know. Her husband passed away 5 years ago, a wonderful man that I personally known for many years, both of them. And she shares with me stories of her children. And she has two daughters and a son. And the son, you know, he's an adult. And she always expressed to me every time I see her, her many frustrations and letdowns and disappointments that she has experienced with her son. And she said basically when he was up into junior high, he was just a really nice, nice boy, a son. But somehow he changed a lot, you know, getting caught up into the circle of friends, keeping up with the Joneses and the society, the culture, and just trying to meet up to, you know, just trying to be in a high position and buying that big house and getting all those materials and wealth and being in a high status. You know, it just seemed really difficult for him to connect somehow to his mother, which is this lady I know. And so the years gone by, and every time I see her, sadly, she shares with me all the many complaints that she has expressed to me about her son. And you would think that after her husband passed away 5 years ago, you would think that hopefully he would step up to the plate, knowing that he is the only son, and just try to maybe take a little bit more care of his mother. But sadly, throughout the years, many times of just letdowns, he would come to her house on Sundays to help to take out the trash, but never talk with her, never converse in any kind of conversation, you know, saying simply, "Mother, how are you doing?" He just does his duty every Sunday, come to her house and take out the trash. And he would just do the dutiful obligations, you know, of the holidays or birthday gatherings, but still there's no heart-to-heart connection. She hasn't had a heart-to-heart conversation since he was in middle school. Something must have happened. He recently turned 60 years old. And she expressed to me lately, which I am just in awe. I am shocked. My jaws were just dropping as she was expressing to me that now, for the last 2 months, to my great surprise, they go out to dinner every Wednesday nights, every week. She would go out to dinner with her son and his wife, the three of them, to different restaurants. And now when he comes to her house on Sundays to take out the trash, they talk, they converse, and things are so much more pleasant. There has been a big, huge turnaround in their relationship. And she feels so comforted today. Better late than never, right? I mean, I was just blown away because I have known this lady for 25 years. And sadly, it has just been constant complaints on her part, complaining about her son's behaviors and his actions and so many other things. And to hear her say something nice, that he's doing something nice, caring, I am just blown away. Who knows? Maybe it's because he just turned 60. Maybe it's just that number of being 60, you know, or maybe it's because all of his friends he sees who just really respects their parents. He watches and observes and sees how his parents, his friends treat their parents who are maybe sick or who is just getting elderly in age. He sees and observes his friends' care and concerns for their parents. Maybe that motivated and influenced him in a good way to take care of his mother at this time. Maybe he knows he's not getting any younger, just recently turning 60, that he just got knocked in the head somehow, just came to his senses. So I just want to encourage you today, if you happen to be in a relationship where you're always battling and conflicts and a lot of hurts, a lot of resentments there, a lot of frustration and disappointments, never give up, you know. Because you never know, just, you know, when people are at a good place in their lives, we're much better, we get along better with others. And when we're not at a good place, it's just that much harder to get along with others. But just have that patience, like it says in Psalms 27, just wait on the Lord, let Him strengthen your heart. Just trust in Him always, for He always knows behind the scenes as we have our heart in good relationship with God, and we are in better connection with God, are we in that much more able and capable to be in good relationship with others? We're at a much better place in our life, better emotionally, our state of mind, and in our heart, and in our spirit, just to maybe, just to have more common sense, to just live peacefully with one another. I hope that I said something in this video that may help to encourage you today to never give up hope if you're in constant conflict with others. And I know that I've experienced that too with my relatives, the ones that I've known for years and that I've always had conflict with. And I just wanted to keep my arms distanced that, you know, it was just that personality that was just, I felt that they were more like very like vicious and very hard to get along with at times. And I just couldn't, for the life of me, couldn't understand where they were coming from. And they just always seemed to be judgmental or critical all the time for many years. Well, I think an alien took over their body. That's what I like to say. They totally changed and are so much kinder and nicer and more gracious and more just a lot more down to earth and easier to get along with. And I was just so shocked. So, you know, people can change. People can change. You can change. Maybe if you are that person who was not kind to others, maybe you can be at that place today to be more kinder, more gracious to us others. Maybe other people need that little extra dose of grace, you know? Let's give it to them graciously, for we just want, it's hard for us to live in this world with people, but that's all there is people. So let us just try to take that initiative to just get along with others and make that first move and be the bigger person. And you will be in awe to see a big turnaround in relationship that can be restored with God's Spirit, and just have that faith, that constant faith, hope, and know that God's love and His grace and His favor will be upon you as you just keep on honoring and pleasing God and just soften your hearts. I'll see you next week, and I hope that you may experience that wonderful turnaround in your relationship that you're in conflict with constantly, and never give up hope. For this lady that I know, she is just in awe with her son's big turnaround and being so much more loving and caring for her, and she is in her early 80s now, and she is so much more comforted, and all the years gone by that they haven't been in this great relationship. But now, after, you know, from middle school to now age 60, hopefully it won't take that long, or the other person that long, just to be restored in your relationship today. God bless you. I'll see you next week, and consider subscribing to my channel if you're interested in hearing the weekly faith and anything encouraging, anything uplifting or inspiring to help us in our daily lives, just to give us that hope and cheer. See you next week. Goodbye.